Philippine Justice Secretary Minal Dugadara says International Criminal Court Prosecutor Karim Khan should have given the government more time to investigate the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. According to Dugadara, a probe of this magnitude and complexity cannot be finished in a few months. Khan had made a request to the ICC pretrial chamber to resume his investigation, saying the Philippine government has not demonstrated that it has investigated or is investigating the alleged crimes committed in the drug war. His probe was halted in November last year on the request of the Philippine government to conduct its own review. But so far, the government has only released a matrix of 52 drug war-related cases out of hundreds, and only a handful have reached the courts. Detained opposition senator Laila De Lima has been released from the Manila Doctors Hospital on Sunday after undergoing a major surgery. De Lima was escorted at past noon from the hospital back to the Philippine National Police Custodial Center in Camp Crame in Quezon City. Last week, the 62-year-old lawmaker was granted a 5-day medical furlough by the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court for an operation to remove part of her uterus. De Lima has been in jail since 2017 over illegal drug charges. The lawyers believe the two remaining cases against her should be dismissed after key witnesses recanted their testimonies.
A Thanksgiving concert is held for outgoing Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte just days before he officially steps down from office. Duterte arrived with his partner Juanileta Avancenia and allies such as Senator Bongo, Executive Secretary Salvador Medialdea, and Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez. Also present in the event, the sister of President-elect Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., Senator Amy Marcos, and Senator-elect Robin Padilla. The chief executive only had a short message of thanks for his supporters, but he did treat them to a few songs as he sang along with some of the performers.
Maiksi lang po sa sambayang Pilipino. Maraming maramang salamat sa inyo.
Martin Rivera, Mocha Uson, Andrew E., Robert Senya, and Isai Alvarez were among the artists to perform at the concert. It was also attended by many supporters from various parts of the country.
Area. So marami talaga. Kaya ngayon na ano namin, na mula nung nagpapat siya ng ganyan, mga tabata, mga kabataan doon, mga ano doon, matino na. May mga trabaho, nagsipag-aral, nabalik, suwila, tapos yung iba nagkatrabaho na. Kaya nagpapasalamat talaga ako ng malaki sa kanya dyan.
Gusto na namin magdiwang ba na inabot natin ang 6 na taon, dumaan tayo ng mga bagyo, kalamidad, pagsabog ng bulkan, pandemya, pagtaas at pagbaba ng mga iba-ibang klaseng presyo. At siyempre, yung ating pinagdaanan ay hindi pangkaraniwan. Sa hirap at ginhawa, magkakasama tayong mga Pilipino.
Vice President Leni Robredo also looking back on her journey over the last 6 years as she prepares to step down from her post. And the final episode of her Sunday radio program, Robredo said her political differences with President Duterte was a blessing in disguise for her team. Robredo, who comes from a political party different from Duterte's, was a target of attacks from the latter and some of his officials and supporters, especially whenever she would criticize some of the administration's policies and programs. For a time, she held the positions of Housing Secretary and co-chairperson of the Interagency Committee on Anti-Illegal Drugs, but eventually quit due to policy differences.
Yung lahat ng mga kahirapan na binigay sa amin, actually yun yung nagpahusay sa amin. Dahil hindi kami tinuring nakakampi, hindi kami tinuring na bahagi ng pamahalaan, natuto kami ka, Eli. Natuto kami na maghanap ng paraan. At to my mind, yun yung nagpahusay sa amin. Kasi pag mahirap, nagiging mahusay kayo. Mm-hmm. Pag mahirap, naghahanap ka ng paraan. Kasi ita namin na yung power ng private partnerships na kapalaki. At ngayon, kaya malakas yung loob namin gawin yung angat buhay. Kasi nahasa na kami. Nahasa kami sa ganun na trabaho na halos walang tulong from government. Pero marami nagagawa. Mm-hmm.
Robredo also says she still has a lot of work to do and some appointments to wrap up before June 30. Her team team is also busy organizing the souvenirs given to her on the campaign trail. Robredo ran for president in the May 2022 elections, but lost to President-elect Bongbong Marcos.
Ang dami, sobrang gaganda. Humingi ako ng para permission ng mga nagbigay na i-donate ko lahat na paintings for Angat Buhay. I-donate ko yung lahat na paintings sa Angat Buhay para maraming makinaba sa mga unang gagawin. Parang exhibit nitong mga lahat na, yung mga exhibit ng mga paintings, pero gagawin din siyang fundraising event. Yung mechanics, abangan na lang nila. Ilalabas namin yung mechanics this week. At ito pa yung magiging seed fund para sa ating mga activities. So sana okay lang sa mga nagbigay. Properly acknowledge po yung mga nagbigay. Malaki lang akong bahay, hindi ko to papakawalan ka, Eddie, pero wala talagang paglalagyan. Napaka-heartbreaking na bitawan yung iba, pero ito, tingin kasi namin kay Eddie, ito yung best way.
Robredo has announced that the Angat Buhay program will be launched as a non-government organization next month.